So whenever I have to do some work, right, let's say I'm doing the dot product of a large vector of, let's say, 1000 entries. So I decide that I'll write OpenMP code, I'll define a parallel region, and I will have each thread do 1/4 the work. I'll launch 4 threads and do 1/4 the work. But how do you figure out that which thread is supposed to do what? How do you divide the work? What happens is that there are calls to figure out what is the total number of threads in the system, and there is a unique identifier given to each thread, right? It's called the thread ID, okay? And on the basis of the thread ID and the total number of threads, I can decide what is the work I'm supposed to do, right? So if you want to do a dot product, and let's say that there are 4 threads, the threads will have ID 0, 1, 2, and 3. Can I use this information to figure out what work I'm going to do? So each thread will know its ID, right? And it will know the total number of threads. Now I can figure out what is the work I'm going to do. I'm going to start from 250 times my thread ID for the next 250 elements, right? I'm going to do the dot product, store it somewhere. And in the end, we'll figure out a way to accumulate these results, right? Knowing the thread ID and total number of threads is important for a lot of things, including the distribution of work and communication. So how do you get the total number of threads and thread ID? So this is the call, OMP get num threads, which essentially returns the total number of OMP threads, okay? And the call OMP get thread num returns the thread number of the current thread. So remember, this code is getting executed inside a parallel region. So different threads will be making calls to this function, and each one of them will get a different value back. Okay, so what about these variables, numt and tid? Where are these? So these are going to be in the stack of each thread. Okay, this is kind of like the first frame on the stack of each thread, right? So since these are declared and defined inside the parallel region, they will go on the stack. The important part is that each thread will have its own copy of numt and tid. Okay, what do I do next? I just print hello world along with the thread ID and the number of threads. So what do I see once I do this? This is what I see, right? I run it again. This is what I see. What do you observe from the output? Print is not atomic. Most of the time, 99% of the time, if you have short print statements, you will find that they get printed contiguously. Okay, but otherwise print is not atomic. The order, right? You can't be assured of what order the output will appear in, or what order actually the statements got executed in. The only thing you can be sure about is that within one thread, the statements got executed sequentially. But amongst threads, in what order did that those sequential orders get interleaved? You have absolutely no idea. Okay, and if you run multiple times, they may get interleaved in different manners, because it's completely dynamic, right? When does the time slice expire, right? So when the threads are initially launched, which thread does the processor pick up first? If any thread does an IO operation like printf, printf is an IO operation, right? It has to print on the screen to an IO device, right? It's not deterministic, okay? You have no idea about the order in which these statements get executed. The only thing you're sure about is that within each thread, the execution takes place sequentially. So that's why you see different orders when you run it multiple times.
So you gave an example in the previous class, hello and then world. It's two print commands. So if we have a similar processor, means a number of processor which is less than the number of threads, so in that case, is it possible that the outputs which we get are like hello, hello, and world, hello, like this?
So that may even happen when you have separate processors. Even if you have 4 cores and you're running 4 threads, even then you may see that output. The core has to write to the output device. That output device is a common output device. It's the same screen, right? Same display. So there is some memory location and some IO port maybe where all of this is being written. So maybe thread 1, this is executing on core 1, thread 2 is executing on core 2, but when it's executing the print statement, it sends some data, maybe it sends H-E-L-L-O, right? Thread 2 in the meanwhile sends its own hello w. So what will the screen print? The screen will print hello followed by hello w and then maybe something else.
So the stuff like data file handling or printing on the console is not a good idea with this.
No, I mean you have to do it. You have to figure out how to make those operations atomic. Atomic means what? Appear as if nothing else is happening within that atomic operation, right? As if no other thread is getting scheduled within that operation. I mean, you have to make it seem atomic. So one way of doing it is maybe, we'll talk about this. Maybe locks, mutual exclusion. There are lots of ways of doing this. So you get a lock, then you do the print, then you unlock. So we'll discuss all those. Not in the context of prints. In prints, typically it's not such a big issue. So what if the print came out wrong, right? What is important is that the file operations must be correct and the data, I mean, when you're working on variables, that they should be managed properly. That is very, very important. That is the most important thing. The main memory, operations you're performing on main memory, they must be consistent. So all these outputs were generated using actual programs, right? But most of the time, like more than 90% of the time, you'll realize that one printf statement appears together. But if you run maybe 1 million times or something, you may actually find that that does not happen. So our print operations are not atomic. Okay. Now let's consider the following scenario, right? So I had declared and defined numpty and tid inside the parallel region, right? And therefore a separate copy was created for each of these. What happens if we declare these variables outside the parallel block? So this is the change I've made. Remember I asked you to concentrate on the red part. Right, so I have now declared numpty and tid outside the parallel region. So what happens now? So when I run this code, I get the output that I expected. I run it again. I get some other output. So why has this happened? So thread 3 never printed anything and thread 1 printed twice. Correct. Now this is a shared variable, right? Numpty and tid are now shared variables. So what happened in this particular case? Thread 3 was, let's say, executing. Yeah, it executed numpty equal to omp get num threads. And in the meanwhile, what happened was that thread 1 came along. It executed numpty equal to omp get num threads, right? So both of them got the number of threads. And let's say then thread 3 then executed tid equal to omp get thread num. So this tid is a shared variable, right? So what got stored into tid? So thread 3 stored the value 3 in the variable tid, right? It's shared by all the threads. And now before it could get to printf, what happened was that thread 1 came and executed tid equal to omp get thread num. So what happened here? What happened was this actually got replaced with the value 1. So now tid has value 1. And then thread 3 went ahead and called printf, and when it passed at the parameter tid, what was actually passed? 1 got passed. Right? And similarly, thread 1 eventually called printf at some point in time, and what got passed? 1 got passed. That's why you see 1 getting printed twice. So this is essentially a race condition, right? When there are variables or resources being shared by multiple threads and they try to update that variable, right, at the same time, then you run into race conditions.